Hey everyone, welcome to a new episode of the vlog. Today, I'm heading down to Seattle to see the Rolling Stones. It's a precursor to my tour. If you don't know, I'm also a professional musician, and tomorrow I leave for Nanaimo on a tour of my own, but today is a pre-tour day celebrating someone else's tour, the legendary Rolling Stones. So, time is of the essence. I should head out pretty quick. Can't wait. Gonna take you guys with me and experience the show. Gonna be awesome.
Update, I am now crossing into the good old US of A. Traveling down to Seattle. I stopped at a fast food place across the border because I always like to get the US sweet tea because it's very different from what iced tea is in Canada. But knowing my luck, they were out. Of course. Well, I'm here in Seattle, and after an infuriating half an hour, I found a parking spot. Hopefully I don't miss any of the opening act, but I'm getting kind of late. But it is worth it to be back in beautiful Seattle. Always a thrill to make another return trip here, especially for a band as legendary as the Rolling Stones. I sure do like the Pioneer Square old neighborhood. Quite an incredible little haven here in the middle of town, full of so much history. Most of the buildings here date back to the 19th century. If any of you saw the last time I did a couple of vlogs here from Seattle, I stopped and visited the Central right here in the heart of Pioneer Square, which is a place that many of the earliest Seattle grunge bands got their start. But more than that, it's another one of those buildings that dates back to the 1800s. And I think it's been a continuously operating bar. Pretty cool. I really intended to get here a lot earlier, but I got stuck in that patented Seattle traffic. And there is an absolutely intense line to get in. And the opening act is scheduled to go on in 15 minutes. Oh well. The opening act tonight is Lucas Nelson and Promise of the Real. I've seen Promise of the Real one time, back when they were Neil Young's backup band a couple of years ago. Not opening act, they actually, Neil played with them for a few years. And of course, Lucas Nelson is Willie Nelson's son. So that's pretty cool. We'll see if we can catch their set. Lines aren't actually as bad as I thought they'd be. This should be fine. And just like that, I'm in. Actually, I give them a lot of credit for how well they got people in really quickly. Looks like I won't miss the openers after all. Beautiful view of downtown Seattle from within the stadium grounds here. Gorgeous.
Oh,
are about to see. About to see the Rick Rolling Stones, Mick Jagger, Keith Richards, Charlie Watts, and Ronnie Wood. 57 years into their career as a band. Can you believe it? I can. It's about to happen. Sit back. Can't wait. It's going to be amazing. I've been here to CenturyLink Field a couple of times now. I've never gotten a chance to see a football game here, but I've been to a couple of concerts. I saw Guns N' Roses earlier on their reunion extravaganza 3 or 4 years ago. That was a cool gig. Alice in Chains opened for them that night. And then last year, I came here and I saw U2. And U2 actually had, of all people, Eddie Vedder come out. I suppose this is definitely a pole in front of us. Just like at the Paul McCartney show I went to, but all in all, not a terrible seat. Especially considering how massive this place is. Quite a minimalistic stage setup tonight. And they have Charlie Watts' drum kit all set up. Oh boy! Pretty iconic. It's always a good sign when they play Kiss as part of their pre-show music. Oh boy. You don't get a lot of the wave at rock concerts, but it's going tonight.
He's the brother!
Yeah.
I love you.
Hey,
And the one that you voted most for tonight was...
Silver. Oh my God! Thank you.
driven all the way back home. My hair is huge now. Wow, look at that. Yeah, back to Canada. About a 2.5 hour drive each way to get there and back, but boy, was it worth it. Amazing show, as you guys just saw. I'm convinced they're all superhuman, being in their mid to late 70s and still jumping around the stage like they're 20. I know that it's a cliche to say this, but I have no idea how they do it anymore. It's just insane. Like, they're one of those bands that doesn't show any signs of their age. Like, I'm especially impressed with Charlie Watts, the, like, unsung hero of that band, I think, because he's, like, rock-solid drummer. I can't even imagine drumming for 2 hours at 78 years old. He's 78. Quite a workout. Yeah, but so glad I went to that show. So cool. Glad I got to show you guys some clips from it. It was a lot of fun. But that's gonna do it pretty much for this episode. I wish I could do a whole episode doing like a concert review of that, but I don't have time. For those of you who don't know, I'm a musician myself, and I'm going out on tour tomorrow. So while I am back home now to Maple Ridge, my hometown, I will be gone again tomorrow, because tomorrow I start my 2-week tour, most of it with fellow musician Leenie Bennett. So that's going to be awesome. For a full list of all my upcoming tour dates, not only for these 2 weeks, but all that I have planned so far, you can see them in the description, as well as also in the description, there's links to where you can find my music, where it's sold or streamed online. Like Bandcamp's a great way to get my music. You can get it by donation. You don't have to donate anything if you don't want to, but I really appreciate any donations that I do get. I am a full-time professional musician, and all the money I get goes towards furthering my career and apparently going to Rolling Stones concerts. Sorry. So there's lots of ways to get my music online. You can find them in the description. And yeah, thanks so much for watching. Like this video if you liked what you saw. Subscribe to this channel if you've been enjoying my vlog in general. This is my 103rd, I think, episode of this thing. So yeah, you can subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video, which will be tomorrow and every day for the foreseeable future. And tomorrow is a big vlog, because tomorrow I'm going out to Nanaimo and starting off that tour. First date of the tour is at the Nanaimo bar tomorrow night, so that'll be fun. That'll do it for this episode. What a crazy and insane fun episode that was. That'll do it. Sorry, I'm tired. It's 3 a.m. now. yeah, that'll be it. I gotta catch some sleep so I can get out and hit the road again tomorrow. Thanks so much for watching. Catch you again with a new vlog tomorrow.